Hey guys,
Welcome to Code and Me, and today we are discussing about Heroku implementation. That is a very huge portion of Heroku, but right now I will discuss about the first part, in which we will just we'll just install it and configure it according to Heroku. So first of all, we have to know what is Heroku and how it's work. And I will discuss today about the introduction, what is the need of Heroku, how we will connect with Salesforce. There are two CLI that is used to connect with Heroku and with your local system. And at the end, I will say about it, that what, how Heroku is helpful for us. And we will talk about Codeenemy. So first of all, we have to learn three things. That somehow in the beginning, around 20 or 25 years before, what we were doing, if you want to build something, if you want to build an application, if you want to build a software, what we will need? We will need the first thing, that is server. The second thing, there is a storage. And that server and storage, we have to connect with via networking. We will use as some middleware, we will build as some runtime, then we have built an application, and that then we have inserted some data. So long time ago it was happening, and that was on premises, that somebody will need any software, he or she have to do it from application to networking, as you can see in that picture in the left one. Okay, next is then there was a thing that is known as infrastructure as a service, and nowadays it was very much popular, like Google Cloud, and you can say Amazon Web Services. So AWS, Amazon, is very much popular because it is providing infrastructure as a services. So we have to take care of applications, we have to take care of data, we have to take care of what is the OS. For example, for Apache and for PHP, we will need Linux. And maybe for IIS, or you can say ASP.NET, we will need a Windows, Windows XP or Windows Server, something like that. So we have to decide about that. Some middleware we will need. We will need a runtime environment, JRE you can say, or JDK you can say. We will need an application, we will need a data. But the storage problem, the networking problem, the area problem, you can say the memory problem, or networking problem, was managed by AWS, that is infrastructure as a service. Then it was a time when systems comes as a SaaS, software as a service. Nowadays we you can say that Skype is a SaaS, software as a service, or you can say we are very much used to Hangout is a software as a service, because it is an application, it has some data, it is running on some runtime, it is a middleware, you can say that. Somehow Salesforce is a SaaS. If you someone or you are doing like professional edition, or you can say essential edition, we will learn about it also, that what is professional, what is essential, but not in video. In this video we will learn about in this future. Okay, so the SaaS or software as a service was that we just have to use it. We will not create anything, we will not you can say we will not edit it, we will just customize it according to our choice, and then we will just you can say configure it, run it, and make it useful. That is SaaS. So you can say 5 years before, the Salesforce was like that, or 10 years ago Salesforce was like that. It was a SaaS, that it was providing only CRM that we can use for lead, account, campaign, campaigning, products, orders, like that. But after some time, Salesforce understood something, and that makes us platform as a service. In that platform as a service concept, what was actually happening? In that platform as a service concept, the happening was like, you can say, we will build an application, we will build something, we will build VF pages, we will build according Lightning component according to that, we will build email services, web services according to that, we will run some modular approach, we will design the how. The design will be how the object design, or you can say table design will be. So So that was platform as a service. So nowadays, some has enterprise edition, or if you have developer edition, you're using platform as a service, like that concepts. So this was all about Heroku. Heroku was what? Heroku is a PaaS. Heroku is a cloud platform that is used, that is multi-language, multi-framework, Elastic, PaaS, which provides everything. What do you mean by this? Something one is Elastic. Suppose you have thousands user for an application. So we will take, for example, first of all, I will take an example. One second, yeah. That is Git feedback and Handshake. These are the two best example of Heroku application. And Git feedback was a website, or you can say as an app, in which there are at least 1 million survey response per month. That this app is used for survey, and in America 1 million survey response per month is using by the Git feedback, and it is built on, you can say, Heroku. Now the second one is Handshake. Handshake is just like a company portal. Nowadays we are using you can say MCAT, like that, that is Virtual University Career Center, in which 2.5 million students profile, 150 plus student universities, 120,000 recruiters and 70,000 companies are there, and these are working Handshake on Handshake, and Handshake is built on Heroku, which is using the database as a Salesforce. So you can understand what is the scalability. So from one user to 2.5 million users, or from you can say from one companies to 120,000 companies, that is scalable using Heroku only. So Heroku is built on that approach. That's why we can say that it is Elastic. And then we can use that was Elastic, so that it is scalable. We can go from one language to another language. We can go for one user to thousands or multiple, you can say millions of users. It is a multi-language. Multi-language means it was basically built on Ruby. Nowadays it can support Java, PHP, Python, Go, Node.js and Ruby also. So you can say the Heroku is an app platform that provides everything necessary to deploy, run, manage and scale application. And applications may be as web application, APIs, RESTful services, using any languages. Now it's a multi-framework also. Here you can see in this picture that in Heroku we can use any database, we can use any add-ons like 3000 plus add-ons are there for services, and there are some dynos. You can say that a dyno is a small packet. In that packet there are some in every packet there is the same application that you have built, the same, you can say, the same OS, operating system, the same server, the same code, and the same data is there. And now suppose one dyno is suitable for thousands user, and on your site or on your application there are, suppose we can say there are 8000 users. So we can take 8 dynos, and every dynos will work in isolation. You can say isolation means they are independent, they will work on that same thing. If one dyno is failed, other 7 will not be failed. So that's how it's an isolation. Okay, we will take a look in the next video how it is actually working. In this video we will just know the introduction of Heroku. Okay, so this is the history of Heroku. Heroku is founded for Ruby in 2007, and then a new CEO has come, and in 2009 Heroku code was written from the scratch. In the 2010 Salesforce acquired it for $212 billion, and then you can say $1 million, and then in 2011 Salesforce and Heroku became friend. This means Facebook app basically works on Heroku, you can say that. In 2012 now it support Node.js, PHP, Python and Postgres also. So there are two things. We have used force.com, you know that force.com is very much available thing that we can use it You can see here, one second for me. This is actually force.com. That we can see here, that is force.com. This is force.com. You're using anything that is force.com. Using this as force.com. Okay, so this is force.com. You are coding something, you are doing something that is force.com, and it is Heroku. Force.com, we can, it is available, it is configurable with clicks, Apex integration and ABI. We can use it in which background in the database Oracle, and this, it is working on the cloud. Now what we can say in Heroku, suppose this is an app of Heroku. This is an app of Heroku. You can see here also. This is an app of Heroku for account, you can say. And we can change it using it. Here the code is basically actually the code is here. Actually the code is here. Okay, for phone change. And then we can here we are using Node.js. We can use PHP or any language like that. And this is also running in the cloud. If I will change something here, suppose I have an account, okay, and have an account, and in that account, suppose the name is coder, the mobile number is this, and the finance is this. And I want to change it to energy, suppose. Okay. So now it's code in. Okay. Now somebody has an app of Heroku. Here I will change it. Code in. Phone number is 9897, like that. And the industry, and want to know that energy. Okay. So what it will do, record updated. This means somehow the record is updated to energy. It is same. Now you can see it's not. So maybe there is a name issue or mobile number issue. We will check it after that. Maybe it's a record created. We will check it after that. Okay. One second. Order. In me, now the name, mobile number is same, and the industry I want is energy. Okay, now we can check. Okay, it's not working. So this means it is creating something. We will check it how it is working. So this is creating code. This is not working. This is creating code. And we can change it using I want to change it to healthcare, so I can change it to healthcare. Okay, one second. So now I can change it to healthcare. Coder in mobile number, we know that, and that healthcare. Okay, now can we check it? Let's see. Voila. So you can see here that we can change it healthcare. There is no nothing there is that we can do here. It's only an app, or it's a URL that you can search it. If you know the name of an account, if you know the mobile number of that account, you can change the industry like that. If you want to create some account in that, you can create it also. Okay, so that's how it's working, and that is an Heroku app. Nothing, no login or nothing required for me in that case. Okay, comes to the name language. So that was the comparison between force.com and Heroku. Now what is the difference between force.com and Heroku? Force.com is basically a managed application. It is it has three updates, you know that, in the winter, in the summer, and the you can say winter, summer, and the next one is, you know that. Okay, so I will leave up to you. You can comment on that. Okay, here are the certain limitations, that is governor limits, you know that, in the for loop you can only do 200 queries like that. Maximum 200 queries are allowed, or you can say 25,000 SQL records are allowed, and we cannot use any SQL query in the for loop. So that does something. The timeout is 10, you can say 10 MB, like 10 milliseconds, like that. And these are the constants in the full.com. Does you know that in Heroku, this is your language, you can choose it. It is elastic, no governor limit at all. So this is the and I have already told you about that get feedback and handshake. Okay, now we will connect it via Salesforce and Heroku. How I have connected, so these are the URLs that you can use it. You have to install this also, you have to install npm node.js also, you have to use git cli also, that we can use it. And this is my, you can say this is my URL. Okay, so and this is the command that we will use in that. Okay, Heroku, what Heroku provide? Heroku provide you can say open source language. It supports architectures, it supports add-ons, it supports bi-directional sync of Salesforce data into Heroku. I will tell you about that. Heroku will not do any code for you. You have to code write your code. Only Heroku will provide a platform where you don't have to worry about the operating system, you don't have to worry about any language, you don't have to worry about any database. You just have to worry about how code works. So that it can provide. Heroku is somehow cheaper than Salesforce, because Salesforce is, and Heroku also provide file storage. You can update it anytime, and it is scalable. So this is very much popular. You have to add a file storage add-on. Heroku does not provide any file storage. So the one line difference that is using Salesforce, that Heroku application will always need somebody to build it. This will be in an in-house or customer outsourced developer team, Salesforce partner, system integrator, or Salesforce services. This means we have to build something if we want Heroku. So somebody will need to build it, and then we can use it for Salesforce or Salesforce partners like that. Okay, so how I have connected it, so that was the main thing. I will tell you in the next thing, in the next section, that how I have connected it. So first of all, I will need I will go to Heroku.com. Then I will, you can sign up, and then I will log in. You have to log in also, and then you will create a new, after the login email authentication will be required, and then after you will create a new app. Then app will be like that, something like that. Okay, the region suppose code name like that. So now the app is ready. We will use some resources like add-ons, and in that add-ons, first of all, we will use a database, that is Heroku Postgres. This is very useful database for everything. Okay, and this is free somehow for some data. Okay, and then we will need, because it's a Salesforce, so we will need Salesforce. Our Salesforce name is Connect, Heroku Connect. So Heroku Connect. This is used to connect Salesforce. Okay, so now in the Heroku Connect, they will ask that which Salesforce org you want to connect. So suppose I want to connect my Salesforce org, I will connect it. Where this? Let's watch and reach. Let's watch. So this is the page, this is TMC first app, and like that, Heroku SAC, coder, this is the coder, setup connection option. So what was this? This is my first app, this is the second app, like that. So everyone is connected with someone. I want to connect it also. So So I will use connect for a connection. The schema name is Salesforce. We can do that. Next. It's production or what? Sandbox or custom domain like that. So I can say it's production. Okay. Now authorize. So if you're a developer, you have to check it in developer org first of all, and then you can use it if you want to use for clients. So you can use it in sandbox first. Okay. So now I'm authorizing this Heroku app to connect me via Salesforce to Heroku. Okay. So now he will ask that what object we will use. So we have to create a mapping. Suppose I want to use account, so I will create mapping. Okay, so I want to use this account. Suppose I want to use account. Now it will ask for accounts fields, which fields we want to check on or we want to update. Okay, so we can select every. We can use account source like that. So this is not main issue. We can do this. Okay. So I'm not taking so much thing. This is the external ID relationship. What do you want exactly? So suppose maybe we want phone. Suppose we will save it. So. Now this is exactly the accessing all the records from Salesforce. Okay, so in the Salesforce I guess there are 18 records. Let me check. Go all accounts. What is the issue? There is an issue. Oh, this is sorry. This was the feeding. I have to check the. Okay, so call account. This was the feed. I went to check the list. So now it's the list. Okay. So how much account is there? 1 to 18. So 18 accounts is there. So all account is now linked here. Okay. So we can check it. It is linked or not. So if there is an error, it will show. It will if. You are changing something, so it will show pending write to SF. Now if you want to do something, we have to create an app. So this was the app. You can check your app also. This is the your this was your app. You can open your app also. So it is working like Heroku colonme.herokuapp.com. Okay, so if I will use this Heroku app, you can say if I will create some, you can say some app, or you can say some HTML page or Visual Force page or Java app, anything, any app that we want to connect to Salesforce account, we can do that. Okay, so in the next video I will tell you how we will do that. So that was the basic setup for this. So this is the resources that we are using. We can use multiple 3000 plus add-ons are there, so we can use it, we can write it. This is the matrix, activities, accesses and settings. So go there and check it. You can also add collaborators. So if you are two or more, you are a team, so you can use that also. Okay, now if you want, this is the Nino that I was talking about. So I have 74.MB like that. I have 512 MB. I have response time, this is throughput. So how the system is working, this is saying. Okay, we can use dynos also. So but it may be paid. So we have to, first of all we have to learn that how Heroku is actually working. But Heroku is very very much popular, so we will talk about it also in the next video. Okay, so next thing is what Heroku can do. So Heroku platform take care of all of the operational components like hardware, operating system, network, server, etc. So developers have to only focus on application rather than infrastructure. So how it is been designed, this you have to think only about application. Nowadays a very much popular thing is Salesforce App Cloud. So we will talk about later, but Salesforce App Cloud is like that. Okay, so that was all about Heroku introduction. We will tell you more about we will build an application and we will connect it. I have already shown you, I don't know, on Heroku. We will connect it and then we will also use Heroku CLI, command line interface, and where we can deploy our app, how, and we will deploy it using what command. And then we will see how it is actually working. So thank you for watching. This is Saif, you know, from CodeEnemy. You can subscribe our channel. Please subscribe it. Go to Facebook and LinkedIn, Google list also, and that you can find it. If you have any query regarding Heroku or Salesforce or CodeEnemy, you can ask in comment. Thank you for watching.